There's a light, a certain kind of light that's never shone.
Hello guys, my name is Hunter. I'm from the island of Kauai and I want to tell my story to you guys. So my story is why I left my mother's house was because she would abuse me, call the cops on me, hit me, you know, just do it all, talk bad about me right in front of my face and to my sister, make me feel bad about myself. And I just don't like that bad energy. I try to be better on myself, focus and do good on with me, you know, be good for this world and this island I live on. And she took me to a lot of parties when I was young and I don't really like that kind. And now I had to protect my sister when I was going to those parties, and my mom would just be out partying, drinking, doing drugs, and I would have to protect my sister from all those people, because you don't know what they're doing, you know, like in their mind, like they could be all tweaked out on drugs and you never know. But I would protect my sister no matter what. And now I don't need to go back to my mom's, but my sister does. And it's kind of just crazy because I don't feel safe when I was at those parties. And I was like this, I was a boy, you know. But imagine a little girl going to that parties and no more person for protect her. Now I was that protector, and I just, you know, like see my sister go on the wrong path and do bad stuff like them. But another reason why I don't want to go back to my mom's house is because what I've seen over there. I've seen cocaine, I've seen almost any drug, you name it, I've seen it when I was at her house. Do I trust my mom? I really don't, because she tell me all these things, she gaslight me, oh yeah, I love you son, no matter what, I always gonna be here for you, I will support you all the way. Where was you at my football games for the past 2 years? The one thing I asked you for do was show up to my football games. My dad guys, they always show up. If he cannot show up for any reason or if he gotta do something that is important, he make the call to my papa, my grandma, my sisters, Auntie Lacey, anybody that's from this side, they gonna come out to support me, because that is right and that is what parents are supposed to do. My mom, she would just take me away from my family. Like on my dad's side, I would go back over there and she would keep me away. Like I couldn't call them, I couldn't talk to them, I couldn't do nothing. I would have to call my father and Auntie Lacey from my friend's phone in school, because I was so shook and I just needed to tell them what's happening over there, you know. They would, she would just keep me away from them all the time. And yeah, it messed up, but I really feel safe with my dad and my auntie. They support me through my good, my wrongs and my rights, you know. But I just here for talk to you guys and be the right guy and stuff. But I really do think this outcome's gonna come good with my sister and me. I think Akua gonna take care and we're gonna get this outcome the way we want it, full custody with my father. I really do think and hope we can get that outcome. Aloha guys.
That's never shone on me.
Good afternoon, good evening. We're on the island of Kauai. We got some super fishermen from the younger generation helping the older generation, the young G to the OG. We got the blue fish. We got the red fish. We got Aquaman's. Who's better than Aquaman? We got NT right here doing this professionally. They're scaling. They're gutting. They took Matthew 4:19, took that Bible, and they're scaling it. They're gutting it. You teach them how to fish, they feed them for a lifetime. They forgot to add scaling, gutting, cleaning, prepping. And what? They eat sand. If you didn't know, there's sand inside his gills right there. And it looks blue. Like a blue carousel.
He makes sand.
Like a blue Hawai'i.
So all the sand that you land is fish shit.
Check this out. Ooh. It's a big beak right here. Call him the bird fish because it...
Parrot.
Oh, the parrot fish here. Because it bites the reef and turns into sand.
Wow. Does that look like Josh Green? I think that's Josh Green's mouth. What happens when Josh Green's mouth? Looks like that. Yeah, you, Josh Green.
All right, we're talking fishtails.
Right here. You guys caught this in North Shore, correct?
Tell me about that. Hold on. Wait. Say that. You want to say that?
The blue ones was red at one time, and the red ones was blue at one time. No matter about the color, just taste the same.
How come they change color?
Over time, they just turn female for some reason. The
ooze. Oh, they're hermaphrodites?
Yeah. They're weird, like that.
Oh. You fuck this, bro. You know what's nuts, bro? If a fish way down in the dark ocean, the black ocean, can fucking be blind for years, it's fucking swimming up to the surface because it knows there's more fish up top, yeah?
Yeah.
But it keeps dying because it cannot handle the warm water. So it feels the sun's vibration, yeah? This fucker's like, you know what? Whatever's vibrating up here, he's like, I can't see him. I need him downstairs. He fucking throws a headlight. You know what I'm saying? You know,
oh, fish, yeah.
He throws a fucking headlight. And he's blind, bro. The thing's blind. Bro, if a fish can do that, we can fucking throw headlights too. No fucking no joke, bro. You know what? You know why though? The fish has no doubt. The fish is like, I gotta survive. I need a fucking headlight. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I look at that analogy and I'm like, cuz I can do anything, bro. I'll reverse engineer my cells, whatever, cuz.
Hey, if need be, need be. Yeah.
Plus, we'll lay net while the other river just kill all of them.
Bye, mom.
Yes, bro.
We'll lay the football field right now, cuz. You enjoy yourself, y'all. We're gonna play football. Come back.
So,
one more football field right near.
Yeah, one important part though of all this.
Really think all the moisture was with the shit.
Is you see all these banana trees, you see how healthy our gardens is. A lot of people wonder, could we get a good fish, bro? We put this head all right here, all you know, a cycle, bro. That's how we do them over here.
I just grab my glass and climb.
Yeah, you know how.
I get pictures of this thing when we made them that one night.
Yeah,
remember that morning.
I remember that guy.
And that Kauai patch over there. I got pictures of it.
The banana tree.
Yeah, the season's all sick. Baby.
Oh yeah, huge Kauai patch over there. Nice all the time.
Nothing is better than the cesspool papayas, though.
Yo,
right? Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. Yo. Over the cesspool.
Fuck the papayas, guy.
The cesspool. Cesspool papayas. Cesspool.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
true,
yeah.
Hey, the uncle peed on coconut tree is the good one. The extra middle, extra beer in that one. Yeah, you went little. Oh, you get nice to me? You the man.
Of course,
bro. Oh, you trust me, yeah? I'm not too dangerous. This is a nice fan tail, though. You can see. This is like a. I don't think I usually catch these ones.
I fuck away my eye.
Right, you guys are so lucky. It's just so fucking hot nowadays, bro. Hey. Back when I was growing up, we had like five. I had one of them.
I can tell you, we just seen blades.
So hot, bro.
Everywhere, huh?
Back in the day, like, my chick probably had the nicest ass, yeah? And we had a couple, bro. Now. All you get is
but you gotta worry because guys are trying to scoop you all. All kind of worry with
bro,
those.
You know, it doesn't even matter. Even Lance Bush check getting scooped. You know what I mean? That's crazy, bro.
Why like, you just run Balenciaga shoes? Like?
Oh, yeah, the man. All day.
Yeah,
these things last a long time. These are like 2 years old. These have lights in them, but I didn't charge it. But these shoes actually last forever.
I have like nice five shoes, pairs. But I live Kauai. I don't even like think those things outside.
Bro, cuz these are the meanest hunting shoes of all time, bro.
Nah, you are hunting those.
Bro, I like cocaine with my, what's her name? Michaela fucking, you know, Teak Owen's sister? Michaela Owen? I went hiking with fucking her in Kauai with the Balenciagas. They were all tripping, bro. These exact ones.
That's so
a year and a half ago, bro. And it was fun, bro. Like, you go, bro.
You know, this gnarly sand.
Because you look on the mud when you walk in the high swamp, all you see is Balenciaga words.
Logo.
Yeah, up the mud.
That's so nice.
Hold the sand.
So, all this sand come out one time. Usually I pull the gills with the guts, but they kind of... I got the gills out.
That's sand. Probably all the panko and the eggs. Probably some fucking ooh nuts.
Fuck, this camera's like right here, guys.
Oh, back on the thing, you're wet.
It's waterproof.
Oh. Normal, all this stink shit on top.
Wait, wash my hand. I don't
fucking. You get him.
A lot of talk about church or what?
That's dinner.
No, shut up. So now we open them up for stuff. Let me see the sand coming out right there.
W-U-B?
Not looking too crit right now.
This shit out sad. I remember.
Oh, I'm gonna have to Google some of this stuff after we're done talking.
What? How do these things bite your finger right off though?
Nah, it bit fucking Hunter.
I need to fucking clean the table.
It bit you and you're fine.
Hunter bit you, yeah.
Did it cut?
No, I have my gloves on.
You know what? The fucking puffer fish will bite your finger right off.
Bro, that'll kill you.
This thing, exactly.
The fucking thing will kill you. Don't ever touch a puffer fish, bro.
But the kind, man, these guys, that's too strong.
I never knew that a puffer fish could kill 100 men, bro. I remember I see one, like, fisherman caught one. He wasn't even going to dare pull the hook out. I see this puffer fish sitting there on the rock like this, watching the sunset. Like, just with a hook in his mouth, yeah? I'm like, oh, I feel bad. I was like, okay, I'm not gonna touch this hooker, but I tried to take the hook out, right?
Yeah.
At any moment, I could have stabbed myself trying to get it out with the plier.
No, I swear I see my boys get stabbed by those hookians. I don't know, they didn't die.
So there's 100, there's enough venom to kill 100 men in one puffer fish. Is that true or what?
The skin's deadly. Some of them are not too deadly, but all skin is deadly.
That's a stonefish, right? Like a puffer fish.
No. The puffer fish is a big fat one. It's like a balloon.
Yeah, but the blades on them can...
The stonefish looks like one grouper. I think fucking...
In Tahiti, you die except on that thing, I heard. I was awesome. When I was bodyboarding...
Small one, you just fucking...
How fucked is that? Yeah, you step and you're just walking on the reef and you just...
Oh, yeah, let's go rock.
I gotta come this side and fucking spray them off.
You want me to move that camera?
Yeah. No, I don't like spray my dad out.
What the fuck you doing? This trailer's mean, bro. Did you make this trailer?
I trade on a trailer with my friend, but I gotta redo them. All the wood, it come rotting like that.
Plywood. 2-inch, yeah. Or inch and a half.
I'm going to slam some 2x12s in here.
Oh, sick. Speakers? Oh, what?
2x12 planks.
Oh, yeah. I thought you meant subs. I was like, oh,
can I just fuck off?
Bro, West Side, why not get the nuttiest fucking chucks, bro? So much speakers inside, you can't even sit. The doors, everything, cuz. The seatbelt, the theater, bro, it's fucking nuts, cuz. Guys get on the seatbelt, they get miniature subs like this big, lined on a seatbelt. So when you're sitting there, boom, full experience, bro.
This guy is claiming that his boy's truck's all gnarly. Maybe we'll just see if his Y Night style.
No way,
the hottest truck I ever heard was Kaimana Stones on back in the day.
He's still doing
songs. Bruh. You know Kelly Martin?
Yeah.
His truck's pretty loud.
Is it loud? Was he have an 18 in there or something?
I don't know. You can hear that thing from a mile.
Kaimana's one, he would drop a can and the can would float midair in the truck.
Yeah, that's not that nice.
Bro, it was so obnoxious, it was crazy. If you stood outside, your hair, a girl's hair would just be fucking everywhere. You just like this, you let go of the can floating there. That's nuts. Levitation, bro.
Levitation. I don't come on a phone.
Yeah.
There's plenty of boxes for that.
Plenty what?
Custom boxes.
Actually, the
news
coming up here.
Well, what am I going to
hope to?
Fucking Kaimana, bro. Kilo, what's he doing?
Isn't the pale nose
one?
I don't know what the
hell he's doing. Fucking Kaimana's had it rough, bro. I remember one time, bro, he's like, gosh, bro, his teacher was always making him cry, bro. And like, one time he came home, his shit was like, you ain't going anywhere, yeah. Fucking guy jumped out the window, come on, he's on the road, big trip, bro. You know what I mean? Fucking sad, bro. You know what I mean? That sucks. Why is nuts, bro? Got no shame, bro. Even if they get dirty, they can leave a box, yeah? Think about the consequences later, bro.
Yeah, he's in
the
I should. You're not going to eat that one? You're going to eat that one yourself?
Whatever.
What are you planning
to do, yeah?
No. Which steak like that? Save it for you, man. Fuck, I don't want to save it for me. Well, Jay, you can put it up. Alright, should I come up? Huh? Okay, my name's.
Cutting off the fins. Each fin is unique. Fish.
So that's a surgeon fish. You see, here's his razor surgeons right here. And this is a unicorn nasialis in Latin.
Unicorn lazy ass?
Nasialis.
Lazy Alice. Is that Latin for lazy? Ocole?
But yeah, you can see Buggers get the unicorn on it, and this is what we call the thousand-year staple. So this fish has been eaten for 1,000 years, along with the nenui. These are the two fish. These fish are really important to the Hawaiian. So every time we go out, we catch one of these guys. We try to catch one of each, but
this thing is the stinkiest fish I ever did clean in my life. My father made me clean. That and maninis.
Manini. All the time. Big Island manini. Fried manini.
Nanuis. Nanuis, I hate clean. I make my father clean those. I don't even like clean those.
Bro, remember 20 years ago when the waters went red? Yeah, I don't think you were born yet. Remember when the Veil Veils came in?
Oh, yeah. Bro, I remember that.
I thought Paul would go up on the shores and kill all the Hawaiians. Bro, it was still fucking red, bro. The whole fucking goddamn island was just red. Bruh, cause it was so easy money. Literally, the dumbest fish on earth, cause one fish. Is here, fucking five fish, one crab.
Fishy. I see you.
Aokini.
They're like a hillbilly fucking what is the one at night?
Come to Kauai, get fresh fish. Chihu. Yeah, you. From Kauai, we got brother Jason right here. He's cooking dinner for us. We got some fresh fish you just saw with the young bloods actually helping us catch some fresh fish. But we got some stuff we want to lay it down for if you guys know what's happening in Kauai. Without further ado, I'll let cousin Jason take over and say what's up to all of you.
Hello, my name is Jason Ladera. From Kauai, Wailua. I'm just prepping some food. Some trial dates coming up tomorrow. Big day. Working on motion, on emergency custody motion for my daughter. On the 6th, 7th we get trial, the 9th we get trial. Just battling this unjust system, you know. I mean, fucking going to the avenues, trying to do them the right way, you know, the porno way. And, you know, to me, your child at risk. My daughter at risk for abuse, you know, possible sexual assault, you know. Fuck, that enrages you as a parent, and I'm not gonna stop fighting for my daughter. I got emergency custody for my boy about 3 years ago because things was happening because of the mother, Stephanie Krieger. So other than that.
So for people who don't know, the case is tomorrow. We're going to go help support. You know, we came out from Oahu, we came out from Waianae to help support this case because we're trying to fight human trafficking, drug smuggling, and the MO we heard is that Stephanie Krieger has been doing some drugs, some hippie parties with this Church of Wub. Can you please explain what the heck are these weird white hippie people doing with the Church of Wub and how that affects your family and your daughter?
I don't know really what the trip's about, the trip to Wab, but, you know, I did my due diligence. You know, we sent some people out there to check out their parties. They don't know, but they exposed my daughter to that kind of environment, and we've been telling the system. We've been telling a lot of therapists, a lot of CPS workers, fuck, even some... politicians, you know, heavy hitters that can make change. But the Church of Wab is this fucking hippie party that, you know, they DJ, drinking, a lot of drugs, who knows. I know a big thing now is shrooms.
Oh yeah, just like that.
Yeah, what is that thing I told you? Oh, microdosing and all that kind of crap, you know. But the thing about it is, you know, they get these bodies all over, Koke, Anini, Beach, and... You know, the camping, like, pretty much camping kind. So my daughter's been exposed to that.
So you were telling me earlier off camera that when they're having these beach parties, because we got rainbow people on the Big Island, like they're naked and they're doing this lovey-dovey stuff. So I can understand the weird stuff. But then when you're explaining to me, your daughter's in a tent while you're... The baby mama is partying with these crystal balls and some craziness. Can you explain the scene of what's happening? Because I wouldn't want my kid in a tent when people are partying and doing drugs and crazy shit and microdosing on shrooms.
You know, she just fucking exposed to environments that is unsafe for her. And for me, as a father, I already told the judge, you know, we already put in evidence like that with videos, video evidence, photos of the mother exposing my daughter to that kind of situation, environment. You mean, fuck, you know, the injustice that I get is
some good size stuff.
I don't like, you know what I mean? You know, gotta stop. You know?
You chill, but
today the flies went on my food.
we're gonna chop them up.
But the Churchill Walk thing is,
how much bigger do they get?
Plenty.
Are these coalies on the little?
Around.
But are these coalies on the little?
No.
These things.
So you're concerned for his daughter, folks. Yeah. And we're trying to give him as much positive PR, mana, and prayers. If you are in Kauai, please do come out and support locally. The perpetrator, the female perpetrator, her name is
Stephanie Krieger.
And she is doing some bad things. She's Caucasian.
How old do you? They get headshots.
From Pano.
They get headshots.
Almost 50. 48, almost 50. Runs a meat shop down in.
What you can do with this
in Kapaa East Side.
When they take this and they
make it on Meadery.
Oh, that's sick.
There you go. So people are going to know locally, right? You know, once the coconut wireless goes through, people are going to start Googling.
Yeah. Honeymoon Meadery in Kapaa, right next to Taco Bell. Plantation. In a plantation. It, shopping center, I guess, where the old plantation store was.
And you guys never got married. No. But you guys have two kids together.
Yeah, my boy and my daughter. You know, for let you guys know, whoever's tuning in, you know, my boy went through some hard times 3 years ago. You know, she fucking gaslighted him, she manipulated him, she. She done a lot to him that, you know, finally caught to one point that I got emergency custody for her, for him, and that's what we're doing now, because there's contingencies that was already put in place in the court that she broke. You know, I already did an emergency custody, the judge denied it, so now we're going in tomorrow on the 6th for hit that up and see. You know, if we can get this emergency custody, and you know, I fucking strongly believe that our cool gonna take care of people that fucking take care of us, because tired of the not holding people accountable for their actions, and you know, being that Hamao culture, but whoever looking, but you know, they know what's going on. Fucking open your mouth. It is what it is.
So we want to support everyone locally. If you guys are tuning in, you know, when we cut this for YouTube, you know, it's not easy for a parent to talk about stuff with their child. And because they're minors, you know, we would be very sensitive with each case. It's a case-by-case basis. Like, you know, we do with the Ariel Sellers case, Julie Harding on the grandma. We know the father because the mother was selling the kids, Melanie Joseph, with their parent, you know, with, and he wasn't the baby daddy for the last two kids. You know, this is some serious stuff going down. So my heart goes out to you, you know, for people. So if people want to help or assist you, what's the best way they can contact you? Because I don't want them to contact me, even though they will. But how can they best help you? Because you're on Kauai. You live here. You're local.
Hit me up. I stay on Instagram.
Oh, perfect. We're on Instagram now. We can tag you.
Instagram, Malkatu Makai. Facebook, just look up my name. You can find me.
Can you spell it for people? The last name?
Ladera, Ladera.
Jason Ladera.
Yeah, look me up. Support me, bro. Because I'm not bullshitting. Like I tell everybody, bro, I'm not a fucking bad father. I'm a real father. And I fucking love my kids. So
support local. Support brother Jason. If you guys are in Kauai, sun's about setting. They're making beautiful food, beautiful fish. Pikachu got to cut onions and mushrooms. Luckily, we bought the mushrooms already pre-cut. Half the job's done. But thank you for their Ohana. Support where you can. Follow them on Instagram. Follow them on Facebook. Support local. Any final words you want to say? For maybe fathers going out, going through something similar to you?
But don't give up. Don't fall for the manipulation. You know, even if the system fail you, you know, I went through all the avenues. CPS, CFS, CJC, prosecuting attorneys, cops, but don't give up. But your kids is everything to you. Your Ohana is everything. You know, but in time, you know, I think time is the key, because the truth gonna come out, yeah. You know, so don't give up, because fuck all these agencies. They don't help me. Fucking doing with the old school way.
Chihu. Yeah, you. All right. See you guys on Kauai. Love you all. Chihu. Aloha.
There's a light, a certain kind of light.
Aloha kakake. Good morning, everyone. We have a special brother Jason here in Kauai. We got our 10 o'clock right here live with Ohana right here to free Iwa. We got the hashtags with Ohana right here all inside for everybody. We got a 10 o'clock. I'm not sure if we're going to let Pikachu sneak in, but we're going to try to ninja our way in to what's going down. And we're going to, objective is to free Iwa, get full custody back for Jason and the family, to get Iwa out of a hostile environment from a crazy psychotic witch. Apparently that's the description from Stephanie Krieger, who runs his meat shop and doing cocaine and drugs and all kind of craziness. So they got a 10 o'clock doc. We'll see if she actually shows up or not. That's her. Oh my God, she's right here. I had no idea this whole time. The fuck? Nobody told me shit. Okay, that's the one. Psychotic fucking witch. Yeah, anyway, she was sitting the whole time. When I said, hey, you see birds, right? I'm an AO freak, even. I'm gonna talk to the shit about her. I know that was her. Fuck yeah, fuck her. Fuck her. Nobody told me so. Come on, motherfucker.
You just laughing. I'm like, I didn't know it was her the whole time. Who were we waiting for? I was just smiling. I was like, oh shit. Too late. I already came out of the mouth. She ran away.
Yeah?
Because they're running away from the camera. They're afraid. Oh shit. Yeah, we're going to put you on blast. Alright. Here we are.
Free Eva.
Free Eva. Alright. 10 o'clock right here. God.
What's the judge? So you guys, we're in courtroom one. Judge Stephanie R.S. Char.
Hey, is her last name Su? Chow Su? She only half Chinese? How you want to get last name Chow? Like Chow Ko? Chow Su? Chow Su Bao? Chow Su Bao is Manapu in Chinese.
Alexi Stephanie. She related to Lum. Stephanie Lum. The Lum Lungs. See, we got humor before we go inside. Hey, they're late. But Pikachu Asian, 10 o'clock, right? It should be 10 o'clock. Since what time you got?
10:01.
Oh, boo, 10:01, they're late, bro. They should pay us. Oh, that's bullshit. That's like the bus. The bus is not coming. Slightly delayed. I don't believe. Why we gotta pay taxes to these people? Well, we got the young support right here. Young G with the OGs. Any words of encouragement you would like to say to the Ohana?
We got this. It's a closed case as far as anybody in their right mind would say.
And what do you think of the crazy lady in black? That's a female perpetrator.
She's a crazy lady.
Wow. Mama, tell us the truth. What do you really think about that crazy bitch, witch in the black dress?
She's not.
Effing nuts.
Delusional.
Knocking farts. Wow.
Lock up the door to kids.
Okay. We got you secretly. So, I didn't know that was the crazy witch in black.
When I tried to give you a warning.
When I already totally said about this. So, what would you like to say before we go into court?
Free Eva.
Jihu.
Jihu.
All right.
Let's get Jihu very loud in here.
Okay, here we go. Someone in the court. The people's court. The judge wasn't in there. It was the county clerk. How come we're in Kauai? How come they don't see Hawaiian? Why is there no Olelo Hawaii translation? There's not even Kauai in here. It's Thai. And here we are. So come out and support Eva. We're here with Ohana. And we have no idea how long we're going to be here. Right? Supporting from the west side. We got Ohana strong, Maui strong, Kauai strong. Pikachu represents Big Island, everybody. Let's fucking go. I saw Wolverine and Deadpool. I got chopsticks. I can punch you inside. Let's go. I'm motivated by myself. Right? We don't even got our full gear yet.
Oh, we have people coming? Oh, dealer. Hey, I got the spear guns back. I'm going to call this boss. This boss is Don Chang on Oahu. They forget Pikachu from Oahu. I know all the grandmas and grandpas. Bro, I know your boss. They're not going to talk smack to me. You might get a devotion, bro. Pikachu was that good. Because they don't want to hear me complain. Okay, so come help support the case. Uncle Jason to free Iwa. Can you show guys the back of the shirt? And we're going to close out the video. There you go. You guys support the hashtag. We can tag everybody. And once I get my tripod, then we'll do some testimonials for all of you. You. Yeah, you. Gotcha, gotcha.
There's a light, a certain kind of light that's never shone on me. I want my life to be live with you, to live with you. There's a way. Everybody.